external actions. You must do this, you must go there, you must be like this. But a relationship is completely different. So we don't live our lives by we must do this because God said. No, we live our lives out of a relationship with somebody who we love. And what we do out of love for God. And His love comes into our hearts, and we can now see things as He sees them. We can see people as He sees them. And you know what? Through God's eyes, He just sees people that He loves. He sees people who wants to heal. He sees people who wants to straighten their minds. He sees people who wants to deliver from sickness. And through God's eyes, you can see people as they really are. And you are loved. No matter how you feel about it, no matter what your beliefs are, you are loved by a God who proved it. He proved His love for you by sending His only Son out of heaven to die on a cross for your sins. An absolute cruel death. He was butchered for you. Not only was it a physical death, but it was a mental and emotional death. Torment. He went through torment in His mind so that you would not have to suffer the torment that perhaps you're experiencing now. And also for your body. The Bible says that our body is a covering for our spirit. So He suffered in the body. He suffered in the spirit. He suffered in the mind. He did the lot. And He did it because He loves you. And you know, I understand that some people don't hear about this, but the Bible says, how will people know if nobody goes to tell them? So that's my job today. I've come just to tell you this, but the decision is yours. I'm not looking to recruit anybody. God is looking for volunteers. Volunteers that would be willing to come into His arms of love and have a relationship with God. They're looking for people to take that first step. You see, God is not going to force Himself on you. He won't do that. He's not that sort of guy. He just shows you His love. He proves it through Jesus. He wants you to understand what Jesus did. And then the decision is yours. Will you receive Jesus or will you keep Him on the outside? So when we receive Jesus, we are receiving the forgiveness of our sins. We are in effect receiving our passport to heaven, because Jesus is the only way to get to heaven. He says, I am the way, the truth and the life. And He said, nobody comes to the Father in heaven except through me. So in one sense, Jesus is your passport. But the whole crux of the matter is that He is the one who died on the cross for your sins. Your sin was the only thing separating you from God. And the job's been done. So you're all totally forgiven by God. Whatever you've done, there is total forgiveness. And the Bible says that God doesn't only forgive us, but He just removes it all from His memory. And when we receive Jesus into our hearts, it's as if we never sinned. So the Bible says we're justified with God. So we're made right with God. We're put right with God. From His point of view, just as if we've never sinned or done anything wrong. And He can help you with that mindset. He can help you understand that you are perfect in His sight as far as your spirit is concerned. And the rest of the Christian life is just renewing our mind. The Bible says that we need to renew our mind by the Word of God.